Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Slay the Spire. We are going to pick up right where we left off at the end of the last episode here. We just got done getting the Calling Bell, which gives us three random curses and three random relics. And we got the Ancient Tea Set, which is pretty decent, Dreamcatcher, which is awesome, and then Bronze Scales, which is going to give us a little bit of a damaged thorns variety that we can put back in the enemy's face. Dreamcatcher is going to allow us to gain a card in our deck when we rest, which is pretty darn nice. Not really that great late game, of course, but it can be quite clutch if you need that one extra card like we do. We're currently looking for Catalyst. If we get Catalyst, I'm not going to say in an unlosable position, but we're in a very, very good position. So we could go one of two ways here. We could go to this store and hope that we make enough money to buy something in this fight, which is unlikely. Or we take the more dangerous route, but possibly the more rewarding route, which is going to be this one. Go to that store here, and then, you know, hopefully we can make it through the gauntlet of enemies that we've got to fight to get to the campfire so we can heal up in case we need it. All right, spikers are your worst enemy. They're just the absolute worst. Now, we have 5 energy instead of 4 because of the fact that we're at full HP with Runic Dodecahedron. Unfortunately, all the poison went to the repulsor, which is kind of annoying, but nothing we can really do about that. We're gonna be hit for 9 damage. Let's go ahead and not. I could go for crippling poison, which would weaken that one, and then we would still be able to get a card draw and still get we'll be able to gain block out of Auric Alchemy. Look at that, we top deck footwork, which is a great start here. It was slightly annoying that Bouncing Flask did go to the same target 3 times, but at least we have the specimen. It's going to transfer that poison somewhere. And so now they're going to both be attacking. Definitely want to get down Noxious Fumes. Going to use Backflip. We have to basically block for 5 more. We'll go for a trip on the repulsor and then neutralize. We can actually weaken the spiker if we really want to, just get a little bit of damage. We're going to suffer 5 thorns points of damage, but we have enough block to mitigate that. And as long as we can stay full HP, which is almost inconceivable that we'll be able to keep this up for very long, but or maybe even through this first fight, but it would be nice. Let's go ahead and kill the repulsor and see where the poison goes. Okay, so now we know that we're going to have to deal with 8 explosion damage, basically. So I'm going to pop everything, and then I'm also going to get a cheap shot on the spiker. Now, he will die before he gets the upgrade, so we only have to deal with 8 damage from the retaliatory strike of the exploder, and then all we have to do is just outblock the spiker, and that is basically it. So 14, let's see, 12 damage. Yeah, he's actually just dead right now. I can't play Bane. Yeah, I don't want to take damage right now. There we go. Got a Dexterity Potion. Awesome. Quick Slash. Sucker Punch. Piercing Wail. Sucker Punch is not too bad, but I don't think we need it. There's only one card that I'm interested in. Remember, every time we skip a card, we also get two maximum HP, which is also going to make us much more tanky. Thanks to the Singing Bowl. Okay. Here we go. We got the Gish mobs. I hate them. Let's do some AoE here. I don't think that we're going to be able to burn this one down. Not without Bouncing Flask knocking, getting on top of it here. So I'm going to call an audible. And I'm just going to make sure that we have enough block to do that. Then we can backstab here to get that one down relatively low. We can actually kill this one, but I'm not going to. I'd rather go for, like, I'd rather spread the love around a little bit anyway. Spread the damage around. It makes our job easier in the long run. It is pretty important to take them out if you can, but I'm hoping we get Noxious Fumes this turn, which we, of course, didn't. That would have been nice to have, but yeah, all right. I don't really want to waste the vulnerable here. So we can knock one of them out now, or we can keep him at 12 HP. It makes our job a lot easier, though, for blocking later on when we don't have to worry about mitigating damage that we could have taken off the board. So let's take him. Let's just take the first one out of here immediately. It's going to respawn. There's nothing that we can really do about that. Especially without our poisons rolling right now. All right, so we have to stop another 16 damage here. I am going to backflip. Got noxious fumes, awesome, but this is going to cost us our full energy though. Because the pain, unfortunately, the pain damage that you get dealt goes directly on your HP, not on your block. So that's kind of cheap in a way, but that's the risk that you take when you go for the calling bell. All right, we have heal hook. We don't have any way to weaken them right now. Footwork, always a good play. Quick slash, we could. What would we want? We want weaken. If we got weaken, we wouldn't be able to kill it. So, yeah. And by weaken, I mean neutralize. We're gonna take 2 damage here. The dream is over. It's unrealistic to think that we could have kept full HP for this entire level. Or either that, or I'm just not good enough, which is probably the case. Again, this is another really awful situation to be in. We can get a full block here. And then honestly, I think we want to go for crippling poison on another one. They should all be dead next turn. So at the end of this, we only took 4 damage on the face. 2 of it was because of pain. They're all super dead. And we're going to regen 2 of that on the next fight anyway, thanks to the blood vial. Got another footwork. At this point, I'm not going to do it. I want to go for the meme. But that's what cost us our last run, and I made it a point that I was not going to make the same mistake again, at least not in this run. So what really sucks is that we actually have pain in our hand now, and that's really, really lame. We have to hope that we get Survivor here, and we didn't. Oh, all right. We're going to take damage here because of pain. Do I care about 1 damage? I'm going to say no. Because we're going to get weakened because of doubt. But you can bet your bottom dollar the first thing we're doing is getting rid of pain in the next store. Unless if it has Catalyst. If it has Catalyst, then I'm going to take Catalyst, but we're not that lucky, I don't think. Another terrible draw here. We can at least remove 11 damage off the field, but we're still going to eat 12 damage here. Yeah, the multiple. The group of 4, whatever you want to call these things, orbs or whatever, these are by far the worst in the game to go up against, in my opinion anyway, for the Silent. I'm actually not going to play anything here because I want the Ethereal card to get exhausted out of our deck, and they're also not attacking. But these 3 mobs, the group of mobs in this room are really, really bad. It's a bad matchup for the Silent. Wow, they're going to actually buff each other again. All right. Got to be careful here. I'm going to block up now so we can take down one of the Exploders. It's going to be a free draw for us. Get Dagger Spray, which is not a wise play. It's not wise because it attacks twice and we'd be eating 18 damage before the Exploder. The next Exploder is going to go to 20. Hopefully the Spiker is not attacking this turn. Which they're not. That's good. Okay. So all I have to do is block 20 damage, and that's pretty easy for us to do. And I might as well. I misplayed that slightly. I could have gotten a strike damage here on the spiker, but at this point, we're not going to take damage because, yeah, after the specimen transfers over, it's GG. So it's understandable to take damage in this room. I don't really feel bad about it. I'm not going to beat myself up over it. We get a free terror. We have dash again, or we could go for backflip. I really just want one card, game. One card holds the keys to the kingdom for us. And it's not in here. Oh, boy. All right. Let's get rid of pain. Pain, you've already done more than we ever could have not asked for. Poison stab wouldn't be bad. But, yeah, there's only one card that I want. I'm not going to buy more cards to try to shoehorn in a workaround for this. And the relic, it's fine. We only have 36 gold anyway. What do we need to upgrade if we actually upgraded? Not much. Bouncing flask, maybe. I think I'd rather take a chance, rest, heal up, and then see if we can get Catalyst. Dreamcatcher. We got Deadly Poison. I will take the improved Deadly Poison. I'm not going to fight the Elite. I'm sorry. We're about to fight another one. This is a trap fight here. There is one more store that we could go to, but we'd have to go through another Elite. Let's do it. Alright, they're all attacking this turn, which is about the worst thing that could have happened. So, thanks to the Ancient Tea Set and the Runic Dodecahedron, we have tons of energy this turn, which is great, because we're going to need it. Alright. Footwork. Get that done. Backflip, let's get a couple cards here. Looking for Noxious Fumes. We still cannot get. So let's see, they've got 23. Alright. Well, hoping to get a little bit of love spread around again. What are the chances of that happening twice in a row? Not two fights in a row, but I mean, the last two times that we've used Bouncing Flask had a total of three targets to go from, and it chose the same target again. So we've got another, let's see, nine. We've got 27 damage coming in. Not a lot of ways to mitigate this, unless if I use my Dexterity Potion, which I really don't want to do. Not for this fight. Deadly Poison is not going to be enough to kill this one. That would be 8 damage, and then we're still going to take some damage here. It's the difference between taking 5 damage and taking, like, let me think about this. If we destroy this Exploder, we're going to take 8 damage. It's going to bring us down to 14. This one brings us down to 5, and this one will hit us for 4. If I don't destroy the Exploder, we get hit for 5. So yeah, I guess actually destroying the Exploder turns out to be a better deal. There's no way that we get out of this turn with the cards that we got dealt to not take damage, though. Which is unfortunate, but again, it's unrealistic to think that you're going to be able to go through the game without ever taking damage. Footwork again. I really wish that we would stop getting burns here. I'm going to take 6 damage here, actually 8 damage thanks to the burn. All right, game. So we're going to take 16 damage. Make that 18 damage. Way more damage than I wanted to take. This relic better be worth it. Oh, good, we drew draw again. Alright. Take another 8 damage here. Alright. So yeah, this fight, not worth it. Not worth in the least. And I deserve to be punished for... Actually, no, we didn't get punished for that. Or Calcum saved me from my stupidity. Ginger's so good because we can no longer get weakened, but was that worth it? No. Now, Caltrops would give us a hilarious... We would have 8 thorns. Why not? At this point, why not? Alright, receive madness, lose 10 HP, sure. I'm not going to fight the elite. Art of War is going to be pretty good. Art of War, by the way, will allow us to gain energy on the next turn if we don't play any attacks. We're going to forfeit going to the last store, and honestly, I'm fine with that. Dodge and roll is pretty good here. Alright, we're at 30 cards now. The only other card that we take in this spot is going to be Catalyst. That's it. That's it. That's the only card that we take. Madness is kind of a weak play right now until I can... Let's filter out some cards here. Obviously, I wanted to go on Bouncing Flask, and I would actually able be able, I would be able to do... to have it, we'd have a 50-50 shot in making it bounce to Bouncing Flask here. Magic Flask. Yes. Yeah, Doubt doesn't affect us thanks to Ginger. So at least our damage is not going to be affected anymore. Nice. Definitely want to weaken him. Still going to take a lot of damage. Take 10 damage. By the way, the Maw is another one of those mobs that, it's not classified as an elite, but it should be, because, I mean, 300 HP, and it gives itself a strength buff, and it can weaken you, is, quite ridiculous. I'm wondering if we should use Nightmare here. No, Nightmare would be better played for Dropkick, or Heal Kick, whatever it's called. Did not get. Alright, so we use Dodge and Roll, we're going to get 6 block on the next turn. That helps me out a little bit. There's Heal Hook, yeah, Heal, whatever. Alright, so Caltrops, we're still going to take damage here, which is, again, annoying. Heal Hook, unless if I find a defend. Footwork is helpful, but it's not what I wanted. We're going to take 5 damage here. This damage is going to start adding up, as we only have 1 more rest until the boss. So, yeah, this is bad damage. Pretty bad. I want a free backflip. Well, I was hoping we'd gain a little bit of extra value out of that, but didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. 23. Man, we are just not getting our... Dude, we have a lot of defensive cards in here. I've been throwing away offensive cards so we wouldn't be in this situation, game. Every hit that we take in this fight is just going to make it harder for us as we head towards the final boss. Or bosses. 32 damage coming our way. think we go for deadly poison or we go for the 18. Go for 18. Hey, we got another weekend. He's dead next turn, but we're going to still eat 6 more damage, down to 30 HP. Oh no, he actually killed himself on our thorns. That's hilarious. I will take prepared. I know I said the only card we're going to take now is Catalyst, but prepared actually makes sense. But this is rough. All three of them are attacking, huh? Okay. I'm not going to attack here because at least we get the Art of War, the proc on the next turn. I was really hoping that we'd be able to get, like, Noxious Fumes or something, but I do like this whole, this Caltrops plus Bronze Scale thing we got going on. That's pretty funny. Get mad. We can actually use Nightmare on Madness. Why not? At this point, why not? And we will fully mitigate. Yeah, I'm not going to use Madness this turn. So we get 3 free skills the next turn, and those skills remain free for the remainder of the fight. And that's, we get all 4 of the madnesses, huh? Alright. Oh, there we go. There we go. There we go, and there we go. Alright. It's like a poor man's bullet time. And once again, Bouncing Flask goes to the same freaking target, dude. I really wish you would stop doing that. You might not think it's that big of a deal, but it is kind of a big deal because it means that, like, it's not burning down the enemies as evenly as I would like, which means that, like, our job is going to be tougher, especially when they can see and block themselves over and over again. And again, we're going to take more damage here. Man, this is, we're getting kind of boned here, I gotta say. We are gonna, actually no, we won't take damage because he's gonna kill himself on the thorns. He's gonna hit once and then kill himself. That's hilarious. Alright, now we're in trouble. Alright, let's weaken you. Use backflip first. Crippling poison's not really helping us. Really hoping that we would get a kind of hoping that we would get a defensive card there, game. Alright. We can block. Let's see, it's gonna be 12. It's gonna be 38 damage. Go ahead and vulnerable you. 16. Actually, no, it's going to be less than that because we're going to kill him on the... That's great. I've never taken Caltrops before, so... Yeah. Shout out to freaking Caltrops, man, because that made this fight happen. That's hilarious. I would not have expected that would have been such a big pickup for us, but it actually made a huge difference. Escape plan is a free card cycle.
Victor, it's not Catalyst.
Look, I know. Alright. We're not going to get Catalyst at this point. The only way that we get Catalyst at this point is to just simply hope that we draw it in Dreamcatcher. That's it. Use escape plan first here. Maybe we'll get lucky and get Noxious Fumes. We did not. Footwork is an absolute must. Get Bouncing Flask out now, just so we have some poison going out. Then I think we go for Survivor and we get rid of Doubt, so we're not weakened on the next turn. Alright, so they're all attacking. 26 damage. Hoping that we get some block. Not gonna happen, so we're gonna have to weaken here. Weaken you. Now this is going to apply weak, but not poison, I believe. Yeah. All right. So 23. We're going to take 4 damage here. It's not too bad. But again, we're still taking damage to the face, which is less than ideal. And by the way, no, our thorns do not activate the Spiker's Thorn. In case you were wondering. Wow, this is... What am I seeing? Okay. Go footwork, dodge and roll. And then we hope that Nightmare gets hit by this. Heel hook gives us a free card draw. Get Bane. Ah. What I was hoping for, obviously, was that Nightmare would get hit by Madness, and then we'd be able to... we'd be able to make ourselves have a free Nightmare and duplicate our Madnesses again. Didn't happen. Oh, well. Hey, there's Caltrops. Good to see you, Caltrops. There you go. That up and running. We're going to have extra energy on the next turn. Not going to use Prepare. There's no reason to. You're sort of seeing the downside of not having Poison to re-enable... the poison stacks, like, it's been falling ever since, so... let's see. And we are just getting... we're getting no help as far as the defensive cards go. We can deal 20 damage. We got 14, 21. We have 30 damage coming up our way this turn. That's ridiculous. We can kill the Exploder, but if we do that, we're gonna suffer even more damage. Like, this is just madness right now. Oh boy. So we're gonna eat 20 more damage, and I'm finding myself less and less enthused about this boss fight. If we make it out of this fight, this fight's been about as bad as it could be, and we're still not drawing our cards. Like, we've got how many defensive cards do we have that actually give us block? At 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8.5 if you want to count escape plan. 9 out of... yeah, we do have... I mean, we have more offensive cards. No two ways about it. But, good lord, we are not getting help. Can we actually kill the Runic Guardian? We can. That was a surprise, but we're going to get hit by 6 damage anyway because of the Exploder. Oh! At this point... Here's the hoping that we actually make it to the boss. Oh, it's the Maw. All right, well, we're probably dead now. Man, that's rough. We got the worst possible time to run into bad draws. And, yeah, even if we make it to the boss, which we're not going to, but even if we did, like, I don't think that we would have had a chance. There's no way. Get that out. I mean, I'm not giving up, of course, but... that's 2 runs in a row now where we've had a really, what I think is a really good set of cards, and just weren't drawing what we needed. Unfortunate. I was really looking for a trip here as well. But let's put it this way, I'll be shocked if we get out of this fight without dying. Backflip here. Looking for trip. We got madness. Sure. Yeah. Dodge and roll is free. It's fine by me. You know, do I need to use both of our potions on this fight? I mean, if we don't beat this fight, then we don't get to go to the boss, period. There's trip. They get footwork. Crippling poison drops him down to 12. We can fully block this. But man, not being able to use footwork is it's a gut punch. Still gonna cause 8 damage to himself, but this is where our fight ends right here. On the next turn is when everything falls apart for us. Yeah, I should have used the strength potion. Not too late to use the strength potion, I guess, but I should have committed to that idea at the start. And here come the pretzel. 24 damage. We've got 22 block. Gotta do 20 damage to him this turn. No, we have to deal 17 damage to him this turn. We cannot do. Oh, we can do it. Wow, we actually got out of this fight. That's pretty amazing. No, we skip this. We want to increase our max HP as much as possible here. All right, well, we get one attempt here, but, man, it's not been, it did, this run did not go the way that I envisioned it. We get probably the worst couple of bosses to go up against without having Catalyst. Cycle Doubt, and we'll cycle Dagger Spray. I do want to use Bouncing Flask now, just to get rid of their debuff blockers, or it's not going to go. That's fine, too. Alright, so we'll go Trip. Get Footwork going. We have to block 20 damage. We can do that. We can use Backstab as well. Or we could try to weaken him. But if we weaken him, then that's basically we're going to take damage to the face, which we can't do. Also, I need to use our Dexterity Potion. I realize that you all were probably yelling at me, Invicta, use the Dexterity Potion before you do anything else, you nerd. All right, I heard you. I'm not going to throw in the towel, but we need a Christmas Kwanzaa Hanukkah miracle here to get through this fight. And live. So with 36 damage coming our way, which is lethal, obviously, we're gonna have to block all of it, which we are able to do. Now the problem is that we don't have Noxious Fumes. Not having Noxious Fumes is a big time sad face, because we need the poison to start stacking up on the front one, and we still don't have Noxious Fumes. Wow. We're able to block it thanks to dodge. But the big damage is coming our way next turn. Noxious Fumes, finally. This is actually a great play here with Madness. Because not only are dodge and roll and backflip now free, that also gets two more cards out of our deck, but I'm pretty sure we die this turn. 38 damage. Do we get 8 block? Do not get 8 block. Footwork. A little bit late for that footwork. So we're going to take a lot of damage. All right, 14 to the face. Here comes another 38, and that's the run. And that really sucks. That really, really sucks. We got so hosed on the triple threat mobs And on top of that, to go up against the Donu and the whatever the hell again is just... life is tough as a silent. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, see you all next time. Till then, so long, everybody!